Hello friends, my name is Arvind Kumar. Welcome to Green Learner. Today in this video we are going to look into about the overview of the Groovy and environment setup, like installation of the Groovy in our local machine, so that we will be able to run Groovy programs. Okay, so let's move to overview. So Apache Groovy is a Java syntax compatible object oriented programming language for the Java platform. It is Java syntax compatible. It means the lots of the features, it is influenced by the Java and syntaxes has been borrowed from Java and similar other languages. Okay, so learning curve is very easy and you can easily learn the Groovy if you know Java. It is both static and dynamic language with features similar to those of Python, Ruby, Perl and Smalltalk. These are other programming languages that are there in the market, and syntaxes of this Groovy are borrowed from these languages, which are best and user friendly to this to make it efficient and more productive for the developer. Next, it was designed by James Strachan, who talked about the Groovy in 2003 in his blog. Okay, so Groovy 1.0 was released on Jan 2, 2007 and Groovy 2 was released in 2012. 2.4 was the last major release under Pivotal software, which ended in March 2015. Ended means it is no longer supporting release of Groovy. As of now, 2.5.7 is latest stable release. Okay. Groovy is now governed by Project Management Committee in the Apache Software Foundation. That is why name is Apache Groovy. Okay. So Groovy has influenced the development of another powerful language, that is Kotlin, which is now supported by Google and is popularly being used on Android platform. Okay. So let's see the features of the Groovy. First is flat learning curve, as we saw in earlier slide. It is based on the Java syntax. Most of the syntaxes are borrowed from there. So learning curve is easy if you know Java and other languages like Python, Smalltalk or other similar languages. So it is concise, readable and expressive syntax, easy to learn for Java developers. Okay, so it is borrowing from the Java, at the same time improving on those stuffs. Okay, next, smooth Java integration, seamlessly and transparently integrates and interoperates with Java and the third party library. Means you can easily use Java programs, Java libraries inside Groovy environment. Next, it is vibrant and rich ecosystem for web development, reactive application, concurrency support, asynchronous support, parallelism libraries, testing frameworks, build tools, code analysis and GUI building. All the features, all the stuffs provided by Java and more on that. Powerful features like closures, builders, runtime and compile time, metaprogramming, functional programming, which are not there in Java, they have been added in Groovy. Type inferences and static compilation. Static compilation means what the type of the variable and methods return type is decided at static at compile time as well as runtime. Next feature is domain specific language, flexible and malleable syntax, advanced integration and customization mechanism to integrate readable business rule in your application. If you can change it as the domain changes. Okay, scripting and testing rule. So it is both scripting as well as programming language. Mainly it is programming, but it also has scripting features which Java does not provide. Great for writing concise and maintainable tests and for all your build and automation tasks. Okay, so this was about the features of the Groovy. In short, we will see in subsequent session by writing programs to see how it is improvement on Java and other languages and how easy it is to learn. So let's now move ahead and set up the environment for Groovy. So you can go ahead to this website to download the .exe and binary. I'm going ahead. So you can download this to 2.5.7. You can go down and see the different versions and their respective releases. So Groovy.3 is the currently beta version, 2.6 and 2.5 is the stable release. Okay, so there are different options, different distributions that you can go for. This binary, source code, documentation you can see, SDK bundle and Windows installer. So I'll show you with two, Windows installer and SDK bundle. Okay, so you can go ahead and download it. So just to save time, I already have downloaded these artifacts in our local location. Okay, so these are the stuff. So if you install the Windows installer, you will get this, and Groovy SDK you will get this. So first I'll go ahead with SDK, just extract it. Okay, so in SDK you get all the classes and environment there. You do not have .exe, you do not need to install it. You just copy this folder at your location and run it from the bin location that we will see. Okay, just let it extract all the binaries properly. Okay, 97, so is almost 53 MB, that is why it is taking time in extracting. So just it is extracted. So now Groovy 2.5.7, so I need to move to bin. So bin is the place where all the executables and runtime environments are there. So if I go here and open command prompt for this location and type command Groovy version, so it will tell me which version it is. If it is the files are properly there and it is downloaded properly, so it is taking time as it is the first time. Yeah, you see Groovy version 2.5.7 JVM. JVM is 1.8. So to work this properly, you need to have Java home set. If I have a Java home set in my machine. If you do not have, you need to set it to Java. One point of caution that I want to say, if you have Java 8 plus, like Java 9 and 11, you point your Java home to JDK 1.8, because when I was experimenting with Java 11 and Java 9, I was facing some issue in launching some of the stuffs for Groovy, like Groovy cell or Groovy console. So you might face issue, might not, so be aware of that and check for the version. If you do not have Java home, you just go to environment variables. Okay, environment variables here and set the Java like this. Okay, that's it. So be sure the Groovy version, and I want you to check Groovy cell that is provides Groovy cell. So Groovy cell is something where you can run your programs in pieces, like you want to run your one liner codes, scripts you want to run. So you can, so for example, I want to print something, println. Hi. So you can run this, right? You got the Groovy. I want to calculate something simple, mathematical operation, 1 plus 2, I can get 3. So cell provides this facility to run your prompt, to run your test. So okay, so I'm just coming out of this Groovy cell. Apart from Groovy SH, it also provides Groovy console, which is a GUI application and handy to test the program. Groovy console, if I write here, you can, so we have Groovy console open now. I can write one liner programs and small programs to test it on Groovy console. The benefit of Groovy console is that you do not need to write the whole syntaxes like you write for the Groovy, like you need to create class and write method something. You directly write the instruction or line to execute, and it will execute for me. Suppose I want to print date, right? So just I execute it from here, script and run. Shortcut, you have controller, you can go with any of the ways. So if I run it, I get the date. Okay, I can use the control R in printing, so it is giving me the current date. Okay, this is the Groovy console. So we saw Groovy cell, Groovy console, and this was the way from the Groovy, that Groovy binary that we installed. And another way to do this or set up the environment is using the Windows installer that I already have installed. You can download it from the location that I told you from the official website. So I am going ahead with installing this. Just double click this. Okay, it is extending. In the meantime, let me close the console. I do not want to save it. And yeah, it is extraction is complete. Select the language. It has four languages. I'm going ahead with English. So yeah, it is the installer window that you need to select next and accept the license agreement and select next. This is the installer location that you can go manually and see. We will show you the installer location after installation is complete. So this is the space required and space available, and next. And this is do not create shortcut. I want shortcut, so do not check it. Install, so it is installing for me. 64-bit version of Java is in my machine, so it is copying the 64-bit Groovy libraries. So let the installation complete. So it is going to take few seconds more. So in the meantime, let me close this command window and this also, just to make the things clean. So when this is complete, I am going to show you the same Groovy cell and Groovy console, how to open that. And this installer is going to add environment variable for Groovy home and Groovy bin, and just we are going to see. This is the environment. You can read it here about the environment. If a reference to Groovy is detected in the path, the checkbox for adding Groovy home to the path is unchecked. It means you already have Groovy home set in your machine. It will not create the Groovy home for you because it is already there. As in my machine, it is the first time I am setting up Groovy, so it is asking me to create Groovy home, and it will add this location in my environment variables, right? I want, so I am checking it, add to path Groovy home. The advantage of this will be I will be able to launch Groovy application, Groovy commands anywhere in my local machines. Okay, so just next. And it is file association, so if there is anywhere dot Groovy files, so open that with Groovy. Like if you have notepad.txt, it opens with notepad. So if there is any dot Groovy file, let it open with Groovy program. I want that, so add file associations, next. And it is going to show the readme, and which will summarize the installation details, like which version it has installed and all this information that you can go ahead with. Let me close this and show you the environment variables. So this is the environment variables. Environment variables, yeah, Groovy home. Earlier this was not in my machine set, but installer set it for me. Okay, it is the installer location. If I go to the path, I can see Groovy home bin. Okay, so one more thing, let's go to the installer location. I selected C drive and then 86, and this is the Groovy folder, Groovy 247. You see the all the files are copied here. So this is the place where it has been installed. So let me open the command prompt. So see, it is pointing to C users and my name. Not in this bin directory, that was the case with the SDK that we installed. We needed to be at this place to run the Groovy commands. If I now run the Groovy version, it should give me the version of the Groovy that has been installed, that it just installed. Okay, so it is the first time we are launching the Groovy command, that is why it is taking time. Subsequently, it will be fast. So, okay, just wait for a few more seconds. It is going to give me the version. Yeah, I got it. Groovy version 2.5.7. Okay, and Java version 1.8. So, you have to select Java Home 2.1.8 that I told you. I was facing some issue when my Java Home was set with any other version like Java 11 or Java 9. Okay, so let me open now Groovy shell that we saw earlier, Groovy SH, which will provide me the facility to run the single liner programs like println hello Groovy. Okay, so it is going to print me that for me. I can execute mathematical operations also. This is 12. So this is the Groovy cell, and next Groovy console. Okay, just write Groovy console and see these commands I can execute anywhere from wherever I am in command prompt, right? So Groovy console is going to, so let me move to desktop. From there also I can execute the Groovy commands because the Groovy win location is set in my environment variables. Groovy console, it is going to launch the Groovy console for me. So I can experiment here, so by directly giving the instruction to console, I do not need to write the whole set like creating class, creating methods and then calling those. Directly give the instruction and it will execute it for me. Suppose I want to write, so shortcut I'm using control run. Okay, date it is unable to resolve because D should be in capital letters, so compilation error you get, that is nice, right? So if I now write, so I get the date. Another way you can go, run command from here. Okay, so yeah, you show. There is one more way you can launch your Groovy console now, so just let me close this. And this is, you can see on top here also, if it is not visible to you in your machine, so you can just type Groovy and you can see Groovy console. You can directly launch it from here. So it has been added by the Groovy Windows installer. I can do the same stuff here also. It is the same console, so I do not need to add semicolon also here in Groovy. So new date I can see. So in summary, we saw the overview of the Groovy features it provides and the environment setup with two ways, by using the binary Groovy binaries that it provides in Windows installer, and show you the Windows cell, Groovy cell, how to use that, and Groovy console, how to use that. In the next videos I'll show you the Hello World program and we will learn Groovy step by step. So till then, bye bye. See you in the next video. Thank you for your time.